Good afternoon, everyone. Let us start this session. So in this session, we will study the vibration measuring instrument. So this is the last part in the force vibration, that is module number 5. So these are the two vibration measuring instrument. One is the vibrometer and second is the accelerometer. Okay. So vibrometer, this instrument, this is used to measure the displacement. So it will measure the displacement for the vibrating body. And second, that is accelerometer. So it measures the acceleration. Okay. So this instrument, these are mounted on the vibrating surface for which you want to measure its displacement or the acceleration. So suppose this is one machine surface. So we can assume this is the surface of the engine, that is IC engine, or it is the surface of the compressor. Okay. So if this surface, it is vibrating with some amplitude and acceleration. So this amplitude and acceleration, it is recorded by these instruments. Okay, so these are the vibrating measuring instrument. So these instruments, they are directly mounted on this surface. So it is just like an probe. And this probe, it is connected to one display unit. So this display unit, it will display the complete waveform. Okay, so by referring this waveform, we can find out the displacement and the acceleration. So this is the actual instrument. So this is the vibrometer probe. So this part, this is the base. So you can observe here, this is the base. So it is actually connected to the vibrating surface, that is a machine surface. And this part, it has the mass of that vibrometer. Okay. So you can observe here. So this is the mass of the vibrometer. So I will explain with the help of schematic diagram. So this is the actual diagram of the vibrometer. So this is the actual connection. So whenever we want to measure the velocity, acceleration, or the displacement of the vibrating machine, then we will directly connect this. So this is the vibrometer. It is connected to one motor. So here we want to measure the vibration of this motor. So the vibrometer or the accelerometer is connected to this casing. Okay. And then it is connected with this display unit. So on this display unit, we will directly get the reading of displacement, velocity, and the acceleration. Okay. So now we will study the mathematical modeling of this vibrometer. So I will draw the schematic diagram for the vibrometer. Okay, suppose this is the machine surface. And this machine surface, it is vibrating. So suppose it is vibrating with the displacement y, and we want to measure this displacement by using this vibrometer. Okay, so what is the internal structure of this vibrometer? So vibrometer, it has one mass. So this mass is m, this is the mass of the vibrometer, and it is mounted on one elastic member. So this spring, it represents the elasticity, and this is the damper. So it represents the damping in that member. Okay, so it is represented as a C. And there is one scale which will record the displacement of this mass. Okay, suppose we want to measure the y displacement of this machine surface. Okay, so whenever this machine surface is vibrating with this displacement, the sum displacement is transmitted to the mass. Okay, because this vibrometer is mounted on this machine surface, and this mass is connected with this base. So whenever the machine surface vibrates with y displacement, this vibrometer, that is this body, it will vibrate with the same displacement y, but this mass, it will have the different displacement. Okay, because it is isolated from this base by this arrangement, that is a spring and damper. Okay, so we will assume the displacement of the mass as a x. Okay, now here one interesting thing: whenever mass vibrate with the displacement x, the displacement which is recorded on this scale, so it is taken as a z. Okay, so this z value, it will be the difference of this x and y value. So z value, it is the displacement recorded on this scale of vibrometer. X value, it is the absolute displacement of the mass of vibrometer, and the y value, it is the absolute displacement of the machine surface. So what is meaning of this absolute value, and z is called as a relative value. So this is a relative displacement. So what is difference between the absolute displacement and the relative displacement? So absolute displacement means it is with respect to stationary frame of reference. Okay, so just imagine this is the ground or the foundation. Okay, and imagine you are standing on this foundation. So this is the observer. So you are in the stationary frame of reference when you are standing on this ground. Okay, so suppose you are looking at this complete setup. Okay, so you will observe the displacement of the mass as a x value. So x, it is with respect to this stationary frame of reference. Okay, and similarly, if you observe the machine vibration, then you will observe the y value. Okay, so this y value and x value, they are taken with respect to the stationary frame of reference, and therefore they are called as the absolute values. Absolute means what? If the observer is looking at the mass vibration, that is the mass of the vibrometer, and the machine surface vibration, then he will observe the displacement, that is nothing but x and y value. So what is z value? So z value means it is the value of the displacement which is recorded on this scale. Okay, so this z value, it is not observed from the stationary frame of reference. Okay, so this z is nothing but the difference between these two values. So we will write this z value as, this is x minus y. or even you can take this as a y minus x. So here I have assumed x to be greater than y, so it is x minus y value. So this is the relative value of the displacement. So the vibration which is recorded by this vibrometer, it is in terms of the relative value or the relative displacement z. Okay. So with this displacement, we will write the equation of motion. So for the equation of motion, we will draw the free body diagram. So this is the mass of the vibrometer. So this mass, it is vibrating. So this is the x displacement. So this is the spring force, which is k into x minus y. And this is the damping force, which is C into x dot minus y dot. So the equation of motion, it will be mx double dot plus C into x dot minus y dot. This is equal to, plus k into x minus y. This is equal to zero. Okay. So actually, it is summation of F is equal to inertia. So what is summation of F? It is the external force. So this is minus, because it is in downward direction, X minus Y minus C X dot minus Y dot. This is equal to MX double dot. Okay. So just take this term on the right hand side. So you will get the same equation, MX double dot plus C into X dot minus Y dot plus K into X minus Y. Okay. Now we will substitute the z value. Okay, so what is z? This is x minus y. So x is equal to, this is z plus y. So replace x from this equation, because we are not interested in the x value. So we are interested in the actual value which is recorded on that scale. Okay, because the machine vibration, it is recorded in terms of z value, not in terms of x value. So this is the z value which is recorded on this scale of the vibrometer. So this is m, and x double dot is nothing but the z plus y. So this will become z double dot plus y double dot plus c into z dot, that is x minus y, and k into z. This is equal to zero. Okay. So write this equation in terms of z. So it is a mz double dot plus cz dot plus kz. This is equal to minus m y double dot. Okay. So you can take this as equation one. Now assume the machine surface, it is vibrating with the sine wave. So this is the machine surface. Okay. And we have connected the vibrometer on this machine surface. So this is z value, this is absolute value x, and this is absolute value y. Okay. So we will assume this vibration of the machine surface as a perfect sine wave. So take this y value as a capital Y sine omega t. So this is just an assumption. We are assuming machine is vibrating with perfect sine function. So from this, we will get y double dot as, we need to differentiate this twice. So it will become y omega square sine omega t, and this is negative value. Okay. Now put this value in this equation. So that minus minus, it will become plus. So we will get the equation mz double dot plus cz dot plus kz. This is equal to m omega square y sine omega t. Okay. Now this equation, it is similar to the simple force vibration. Okay. So we will write its solution as, so its solution, that is solution for this equation, this z, that is the displacement recorded on the scale, this is equal to the capital Z means its amplitude. Okay, so it is similar to, if you write x is equal to a sine omega t minus phi. So for x, this a is the amplitude. Okay, similarly for z is the capital Z is the amplitude, sine omega t minus phi. Okay, so this is the equation for displacement, that is a z, which is recorded by the vibrometer. Then we will write the capital Z value. So this is equal to m omega square y upon k minus m omega square bracket square plus c square omega square. Okay. So this equation, it is written by referring the simple force vibration derivation. Okay, and if you divide the numerator and denominator by the stiffness, so dividing numerator and denominator by the stiffness k, so just divide this by k and this. Okay, and try to simplify this equation, so finally you will get the equation for capital Z as, so this is y into omega upon omega n bracket square upon the square root 1 minus omega upon omega n square bracket square plus 2 zeta omega upon omega n square. Okay, so we can take omega upon omega n as a frequency ratio, so we will assume small r as a omega upon omega n, and take this y in the denominator on the left hand side, so it is a z upon capital Y, this is equal to r square upon square root 1 minus r square bracket square plus 2 zeta r bracket square. Okay, so this equation, it is for the vibrometer. Okay, so whenever we want to design the vibrometer, we should refer this equation. So now here z value, it is nothing but the recorded value for displacement by the vibrometer, and capital Y value, it is the actual value. Okay, so whenever we design the vibrometer, we will expect the Z value, that is the recorded value, it must be or nearly equal to Y. So then we can say the design instrument, it is the perfect instrument. Okay, so we need to minimize this error between Z and Y, and therefore we need to adjust the right hand side. Okay, so how we can adjust the right hand side? So we need to draw the graph. So this graph, this is called as a characteristic curve for the vibrometer. So this characteristic curve, it is drawn for Z upon Y versus the frequency ratio, that is omega upon omega n, for various values of damping factor. Okay, so for Z upon Y, we have the equation. So this is equal to R square 1 square root 1 minus r square bracket square plus 2 zeta r bracket square. Okay. So this graph, it is similar to the graph of rotating unbalance because both are having the same equation. So here we select different values of zeta starting from 0 in 0.1, 0.2, then overdamp 1, 2, 3, similar. So if I select zeta 0, so we will observe such graph. Sorry, the graph will start from 0 value. So this is the first graph for zeta 0. This is for zeta 0.1. So as we increase the damping factor, then the peak value, it will decrease. So this is zeta 0, this is zeta 0.1, so this is 0.3, 0.6, this is 0.7, this is 0.707, then 1, and if you increase, then we'll observe similar graph for overdamped system, 1, 2, 3. So from this graph, we will select the proper frequency zone for the vibrometer. So this is equation for vibrometer. So for accurate instrument, accurate vibrometer, Z value, that is a recorded value, it must be equal to Y. That is the actual value of the machine surface. Okay. So when we can achieve this condition, Z nearly equal to Y, if the right hand side, it becomes 1. Okay. So for this equation, you must get the value nearly equal to 1. So if you select the frequency region, that is a frequency ratio. So this is a frequency ratio, omega upon omega n, that is a R, which is greater than 3. That is the higher frequency zone. Okay, so in this region, which is a greater than 3, you can observe here, all these graphs, they are approaching to one value of this ratio Z upon 1. This is called as a magnification factor for a vibrometer. Okay, so if you select the frequency zone, if R value, that is omega upon omega n, is greater than 1, or greater than 3. Okay. So if you put this value 3 in this equation, then you can observe this complete term, it nearly becomes 1. Okay. So this is the design region for the vibrometer. So you can write here, this is the vibrometer. So this is higher frequency zone, higher frequency ratio zone. To be specific, it is greater than 3. Okay. So for design of vibrometer, we need to select the frequency region where omega upon omega n, it will be greater than 3. Okay? Because if omega upon omega n is greater than 3, then this factor z upon y, it is nearly equal to 1. Or right hand side, that is our r square in the square root 1 minus r square square plus 2 zeta r square, it will become nearly equal to 1. Okay, so even you can try this, just put the value of r as a 3. Okay, select any value of zeta, then this complete answer, it will become nearly equal to 1. Okay, so this is the design region or a design zone for the vibrometer. Okay, so this is all about the vibrometer. Now, with reference to same equation, we will design the second instrument, that is called as the accelerometer. Okay, so for the accelerometer, our aim will be to record the value as the acceleration. So this instrument, accelerometer, it measures the acceleration. So we will take the reference of same equation, z upon y, this is equal to omega upon omega n, that is r square upon the square root 1 minus, I will just write r, so r square square plus 2 zeta r bracket square. Okay, now just we will rearrange the term in this equation so that we can write the left hand side in terms of acceleration. Okay, so what is acceleration? If I write the simple equation, x is equal to a sine omega t, so it is representing the displacement. Okay, and a is the maximum value of that displacement. Velocity, we can write as a x dot, just differentiate this equation, so it will become a omega cos omega t. And again, differentiate x dot. So we will get the acceleration, which is a x double dot, that is equal to minus a omega square sine omega t. Okay. So if a is the value of displacement, then a omega square is the acceleration. Okay. So just observe the right hand side. We have the similar term on the right hand side, omega square and omega n square. Okay. So just I will write here. Z upon y square. So we can take this omega square and omega n square. So I will write this equation as omega square upon omega n square into 1 upon the square root. Okay. So just cross multiply this. So take omega n square on the numerator and omega square in the denominator. So this is omega n square and y omega square. This is equal to 1 upon the square root 1 minus r square bracket square plus 2 zeta r bracket square. Okay. Now this term z omega n square, this is called as a recorded value of acceleration. And y omega square, this is called as the actual value of acceleration of that machine surface. So equation becomes recorded acceleration upon the actual value of acceleration. So this is equal to 1 upon the square root 1 minus r square plus 2 zeta r bracket square. Okay. Now here, when we design the vibration measuring instrument as an accelerometer, we will expect that this recorded value, it must be equal to the actual value. Okay. Then we can say the instrument is accurate instrument. So for that, we need to make this term as a 1. Okay. Then only recorded value, it will become equal to the actual value. Okay. So for that, we need to select the frequency region. Okay. So by referring the previous graph, that is a characteristic curve. So the frequency region for the accelerometer is less than 1. So accelerometer, it is designed in the low frequency ratio region. Okay. So this is 0.6. And this region from 0 to 0.6, this is called as an accelerometer. Okay. So if you select the frequency, that is a frequency ratio, which is a R, to be less than 0.6. And if you check this value, this complete value, then you will observe it becomes nearly equal to 1. Okay. So for that, this 1 minus r square plus 2 zeta r bracket square, it will be approximately 1 value. Okay, and therefore the recorded value, it will become nearly equal to the actual value of acceleration. So the actual values, when we design the accelerometer, the frequency range is 0 to 0.6, and the damping factor, that is a zeta, it is between 0.65 to 0.7. Okay. So if these are the values of zeta and the frequency ratio, then you will get this complete factor, which is very close to 1. Okay. And then the recorded value, it will become equal to the actual value of acceleration. So for good accelerometer, the omega n value, that is a natural frequency of that instrument, it is selected as up to 10,000 hertz. Okay. So whenever we have the very high value of omega n, then in this ratio, so if we increase the omega n value, suppose omega is a constant, that is external frequency, then if you are using the very high frequency, high natural frequency instrument, then this ratio, it will automatically decrease. Okay. And it will approach to zero value, nearly zero value. Okay. And therefore we will get very good result for the recorded value. That is a z into omega n square. This is the recorded value of acceleration. Okay. So instrument, it will become more accurate if you select very high frequency, high natural frequency for the given instrument. So for the design of vibration measuring instrument, whether it is a vibrometer or accelerometer, you need to refer this basic graph, that is a characteristic curve. Okay. From this graph, you can select the proper region to design the vibrometer. So this is the vibrometer. Vibrometer is called as high frequency ratio instrument. an accelerometer, this is called as a low frequency ratio instrument. Okay. So vibrometer, so it is designed in high frequency ratio region, and the accelerometer, so it is designed in low frequency ratio region. Low frequency ratio region means accelerometer has very high natural frequency, that is omega n, and vibrometer, it is having low natural frequency, low value of omega n. So vibrometer is a low frequency instrument, and accelerometer, it is the high frequency instrument, high natural frequency. Okay, so this is all about the vibration measuring instrument.